All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios, and welcoming back in the studio, Don Lay, the president and CEO of Medallion Resources. And Don, it's great to have you in the studio again.
Good to see you again, Steve.
A couple of things we want to talk about, but before we do that, let's get a quick update on the company. Still working on stuff in Saskatchewan?
We are. We're doing our metallurgical test work there, sort of the final stage of it before we get to economic studies. So we're excited about that, and great progress. Hope to report on that within a few weeks.
Okay, we'll look forward to hearing about that. Obviously, you're in the business of rare earth metals, and they've been in the news a lot lately, specifically because basically off of one picture.
Right.
And that was a picture of the Chinese president, Xi Jinping, touring a rare earth metals facility.
Yeah.
And that caused a bit of a stir because, as people know, China and President of the United States, Donald Trump, are in a bit of a tussle right now.
Right.
And the result is that if the U.S. decides to put in bans or trade embargoes, anything like that, China may do it with rare earth metals. And that is scaring you at night, thinking it's an opportunity for you at night. What is it?
Well, from our perspective as a potential supplier of rare earths outside of China, it's great and welcome news, and not unexpected, because, you know, China produces 80% of the world's rare earths. They've controlled the marketplace for years, and it's a sensitive area. And there was a big trade spat with the Chinese had with Japan in 2010, and prices skyrocketed. So this has sort of been a potential looming issue, and this visit to the factory just sort of highlighted that it's now front and center. So we saw a big reaction in the markets for it, and you know, trade wars come and go, but this one seems to be accelerating, and now rare earths are a part of it. So
why rare earth metals? Is it just the world is electrifying the vehicles? Is that what it is? Why rare earth metals?
Well, rare earths are used in a whole bunch of technology applications, everything from smartphones to missile guidance systems, and you name it. So it's a small industry, $4 or $5 billion a year, but it's where rare earths get used, and the importance of those strategically, complex value chains and high tech materials of all sorts require rare earth elements just to function.
Right.
And so this, it's that sensitivity to it. And China, as I mentioned, long controlled that marketplace. And of course, they've got their plans for becoming the world's manufacturing powerhouse, called Made in China 2025. And rare earths are a part of that, in control of rare earth value chain and other materials as well. But rare earths are probably the most sensitive.
And there, the Chinese stocks of those companies are doing quite well. But there's also stocks in Canada and the United States that are doing extremely well, also in rare earth metals, over this. Because I think there's a lot of companies, and you included, that think this is what we've been waiting for, a chance to push out China and show the world what we can do here in North America.
Yeah, so there's a lot of companies, Australian and Canadian companies mostly, which are trying to bring rare earth projects to production. And that Chinese have long dominated the market, but everybody's waiting for this opportunity, and now might be this potential based on in part on the trade war. But you know, to your point, like, what's driving the rare earth marketplace broadly is the use in the magnet metals and electrification. So even though the trade war is a topical at the moment,
sure,
and high profile and all that, there's really underlying huge demand for these products. And so the Chinese are now importing rare earth ores, and so the size of the market is going to increase dramatically over the next 10, 20 years.
How do you take advantage of that?
We take advantage of it because we're using a byproduct mineral, so we can access it more cheaply and easily and process it, get to production quickly and with less capital. So we could be in production 2-3 years versus 5 to 10 years for a mining project at maybe 10 to 15% of the capital requirements. So that's why we're very excited about the opportunity as it's being, it's appearing at the moment. So.
Yeah. Last question for you. And as I know you're not in the middle of this trade dispute, but thankfully, especially with the rhetoric coming out of the U.S. president, but, where do you see this all going? Do you see them solving this and getting a deal done on this?
Well, you know, whether they get a deal done in the broad terms or not, I think the Chinese have said that they're prepared to hunker down, and so, you know, it could be a protracted trade dispute.
Yeah.
I don't expect either side to give in easily, and of course there's the face side of it, people not wanting to do that. So yeah, you know, it's probably likely going to last at least the balance of this year, the trade tensions, I would expect.
It'd be interesting to watch it for sure and see how things go on in your side of the market as well. So great to talk to you again. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Steve. Appreciate it.
All right, it's Don Lay, the president and CEO of Medallion Resources.